What's going on, guys? It's Shotgun here, and I'm going to be giving you a bit of a just a short race here on NASCAR Heat Evolution. We got Chris Buescher here, best driver ever. Not really, but he's gonna win the championship this year. Mark my words. So we're gonna do a quick race here. Should be take about 10 minutes. And here we go.
Get set. The race is going green. There's a green flag. Car high. Clear high.
We're running on simulation mode with full damage. The AI is at 95, I believe. And they are pretty good. Whoa, boy, this thing is loose. Joey. I see you down there, Joey. No, Joey. No. Stay back there. The AI goes up to 105. So they're only at 95 right now. They're actually running pretty good with the challenge. So I'm looking forward to trying them out on 105 and seeing actually how difficult they are. If I remember correctly, this is the same difficulty slider they used in Dirt to Daytona. And the AIs in that game were brutal at high difficulty, so I'd imagine this is going to be the same here in NASCAR Heat Evolution. My thoughts on the game so far, not too bad. Yeah, there's some things that I like, but there's some things that I don't like that could be improved or need to fix. I have not caught the caution yet, even though I've flipped over and flipped over the catch fence. And still no caution, so I don't know if that's something DMR needs. I think that's something DMR needs to fix. You know. In an update.
What do you go?
The sound I kinda like. But they're exactly the same as Dirt to Daytona. Which, the sounds in that game weren't too bad, but honestly the sound is just a copy and paste of what was in Dirt to Daytona. It's not bad, but it could use a bit too. The driving, I kinda like it. The driving feels really good, the tracks feel all different. I raced at Atlanta and I raced at Charlotte, and Charlotte is by far way harder than Atlanta is. So, I like the variation of tracks and everything. One thing that's bothering me is the cameras. I mean, not that they're bad camera views, but you can't look back like you could in the previous titles. You can't look around or anything. You can't look at the front of your car and look around. I mean, you can look around a little bit. That's as far as it goes. And you can turn around a little bit in the hood view as well. But as far as being able to look around, look at the car, look back, and look around, you can't do that. So that's kind of a step backwards, honestly. Yeah, I like the way the car feels. I think it could be a little bit looser. But again, that's something you can adjust in the setup. I'm pretty sure. I'm going to use the color user. I'm not joining your party, go away. The graphics aren't too bad. I mean, they kind of look like a PS3 game, honestly, but they don't look too bad. And they're passable, I guess. The replays actually look really cool though. That's what I like. But something that's bothering me about the replay too is you can't switch cars during the replay. Like if I wanted to look at what Joey Logano is doing right now in second place, I can't do that. I can only look at my car in the replay, which kind of sucks. But then again, you know, this is only the second day it's been out. So. And you have the ability to put out patches now. Something you couldn't do 15 years ago when it was
going.
Thank you, Bobby. But I haven't tried to race online yet either, so I don't know if it's better than... I've heard it's better. Some people say that they have a 30-minute lobby with pretty much no lag, which is pretty nice. As I recall, the the technical games were trash online. They couldn't hold a lobby for more than five people. And if you did, they'd disconnect after like two laps. So it's hopefully an improvement over that. And you technically didn't set the bar very high, honestly. I'm going to be racing in a league coming up probably in about a month here, so that's going to be cool. Race with about 30 drivers. Don't go on the apron, please. Yeah, if you turn on the apron, you are likely to spin. That's probably what would happen in real life, too, the real life NASCAR. You can't really get you loose off the corner, really. You get a little bit loose, but it's pretty stable. And the default setups are pretty good. I'm not sure what they're using for default setup, but and what you would compare it to in a real NASCAR race. AI feels better. I mean, they don't randomly brake check. I haven't tried Talladega yet, but in Daytona. But they don't brake check in the middle of the corners if you're doing the technical teams, which is really good. And they actually have, like, something that you kind of couldn't do either is actually have the lower tier drivers in the back, as well as being real race, real equipment. Minus, you know, Chris Buescher being in the lead, which is who I am. Come on, Ellis. They didn't brake check me, though, which is good. Oh, I ran into him. Oh, boy. I wish there was a button on his back, but there isn't, so I hope that's something we can implement. I also want to, one thing that would also be good is implement custom button mapping.
You're all clear, 10 laps to go.
Yeah, I'm just getting the controller fixed on the controller, so you can't adjust it. Like if you want to, in racing games they usually use triangle and square for shifting, upshifting and downshifting. There's no way to do that. It's just locked to R1 and L1, which I really don't like.
Clear high.
Okay, quiet spotter. I really don't like to use the triggers, the bumpers on here on PS4 for shifting, but I
should
expect here. Get up there. I think this is 2014.
All clear.
Oh man.
Car low. Clear low.
I like to go in the cockpit view, you can actually see them a little bit. You can adjust steering sensitivity. And I like that it's controller friendly. You can actually race on a controller. You don't have to have a wheel to be competitive. Because on a wheel, usually you get extra turning radius. In this game, they fixed it so that if you have a controller, you actually have a little bit of a...
Still there?
If you only turn the analog stick about halfway, it'll be turning flying into the corner, and if you turn it more, it's just going to be cooking the tires. So I like that that CPDMR did. I like that for Monster Games that were developed. Excuse me, I'm just being American here. So far, game, what is it rated? 7 out of 10 so far. And there's some things that could use, there's some very simple things we need to work on. As far as like the NASCAR experience so far, it's not too bad. As far as the console experience is, better than New Technics. I will say that right now. Because the AI isn't freak checking me at every chance it gets. I just hope it's possible to race at Martinsville and Bristol and all those tracks.
Because clear low!
In the old game, it was just impossible. You couldn't beat the AI. You get something really down, like 65%, you still couldn't beat them. You just couldn't get through the field. DMR, I think, has done a much better job with the AI in this game. That's something they've been working on. How is Bubba Labonte in 26? How is Bubba Labonte in 26 when he's the spotter? Oh, boy.
Still there?
There's a fun fact, the voice goes off.
All clear.
The spotter in this game, which is the man you just heard talk, is probably Labonte, the former champion, which is pretty cool. Get on Paul Menard. Let's try to highline, see how that works. Looks like I might be able to push
still
off.
There.
All
clear. Let's
try this lap to see how the final one goes. Oh, hi Newman. What? Get flew off his car.
I'm
gonna flew off. Off of my car. Did I get damaged from that? No, I'm good. This time flew off of Newman's car. Let's try the high line to help me. Get all 22 tracks in the NASCAR circuit. So you have all concussion and all those. You have to unlock them as you go through. You have to earn speed points to unlock them. Which is, just hit the wall. The high line isn't really working for me. Get ready to hit the wall. My tires are getting a little worn too. It's been a long run.
Still
about,
there.
Clear lap race. This is kind of a long run. But we're getting close to the end here. So. Lucky for you guys. Come on, Reagan. Wait, Dr. Dr. Pepper. At least they have competitive cars that should be up there.
Still there. Clear left.
You know, Joey Logano, Jimmy Johnson, Kyle Busch, Brad Keselowski, those are the guys you would think
you
would be in the lead close to it in a real race on Sunday. I remember one time on NASCAR 14, I think it was.
You're all clear.
They actually had, Danica actually won a race at Las Vegas. I think second was Landon Castle. I think third was someone, was also someone crazy, like J.J. Yaley, I think. So, yeah, those guys.
Still there.
Yeah, they're
all clear.
And girls are not very good.
Car low.
The morning,
clear low.
Las Vegas is probably fuel mileage. That's a track I look forward to racing this game too. I always like that track. I look forward to racing during my league also. So we're getting to the end here. We have about a lap to go when we come up here. Probably got a 14.6 second lead. I'm like, we are blown away this field.
Great job.
Oh, that was the last lap. Wow. My speed reading 100. Oh man, there we go. So I guess it's technically called mastering the track. There we are. I'll show you the replay real quick. Here it is. The replay actually looks really nice. It's a smooth frame rate, it doesn't tank like the replays do in NASCAR 15 on PS3, at least they tank a lot. This one's nice steady frame rate in the replay. The replays actually look really good too. Yeah, that sound is just weird. Honestly, it sounds a little bit more like IndyCar than NASCAR. I think DMR may need to redo some of those sound bites. But that's the replay system on the lap. I'm sure you can't change cars. So. That is it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you down the road. Congratulations. Thank you.